Well, now it's the Nationwide Football League Extra.
Nationwide Football League Extra, in association with the Nationwide Building Society.
Well, the game's back and the stakes are higher than ever. And once again on ITV each Monday night, we'll bring you all the goals and the news that matters from the Football League. For each of the 72 clubs, there are hopes and fears, but for all of them, there's a new look. From Main Road to Millwall, it's the Nationwide League. The new sponsors have invested more than £5 million over 3 years. For the 24 First Division clubs, it's all about emulating Sunderland's championship success of last season.
Michael Gray's come in field a bit. Benatriba! Oh, what a stunning goal for Michael Gray! That was a Premiership quality goal, if ever you've seen one.
In Division 2, Steve McMahon took Swindon straight back up. Oxford United made a late sprint into second place. So near, so often, Preston's passionate support were rewarded with a championship season in Division 3. Then came the playoffs, football's white-knuckle ride at Wembley, where each year the sense of drama just gets better.
Stevie Claridge has given Leicester a place in the Premiership.
This summer, the Second City has seen the second coming of Trevor Francis back at Birmingham. His predecessor, Barry Fry, won't be sacked by Peterborough. Barry's bought the club. And after big money offers from all around the world, Terry Venables is the director of football at Portsmouth. Well, there's a new man in charge at one of Terry Venables' old clubs. Media tycoon Chris Wright aims to make Queen's Park Rangers the heart of a sporting empire in London by the turn of the century. We'll speak to Rangers' new Mr. Wright after all the goals from Division One. The favourites were first to play, 30,000 were at Main Road. Curl and Quinn might have gone, but nobody seems to care too much. Georgi Kinkladze is still around, and the gifted Georgian conjured the season's opening goal. Floating, feinting, and then crossing. Steve Lomas couldn't miss. If only all City's foreigners were as convincing. The German defender Michael Fronsenk struggled in the Premiership, and he started badly in the Nationwide. Fronsenk was sent off for that professional foul. And Alan Ball endured an awful last half hour as Ipswich used their extra man. Alex Matthey and Ian Marshall hit the woodwork, but the side who won just 9 league games last season held on to make it 1 out of 1.